pronunciation of the week is xylophone.
We're the Paul's Valley News Crew. I say we walk from the lakes and go down the pool. On to the next to dance with the pool. Jump on my shoulders. You can jump on my shoulders. We walk from the lakes and go down the pool. On to the next to dance with the pool. Jump on my shoulders. Welcome to episode 3 of Panther News. I'm Marissa Gordon.
And I'm Dexter Dutton. These are today's top stories.
This has been a good season for the Marching Panthers. At Tishomingo, the band got first place in their division for field marching. The following Tuesday at the OSSA Regional Marching Contest, our band received a superior. That Saturday, Paul's Valley hosted our fourth annual parade and field competition, which they received the highest score in parade and field, even though they were only exhibition.
A few weeks ago, the OU band made a stop in Paul's Valley. This visit was made possible by our very own director, Mr. Drew Etheridge. This is the third time in 7 years that the Pride of Oklahoma has stopped here on the way to the OU-Texas game. They came and used our field to practice and show potential members how they work. A couple of our PV alumni are in the Pride. Many of you know them. They are Caleb Wood and Tristan Tracy, and we now have an interview with them.
I'm Alaska with Panther News, and I'm here with Caleb Wood and Tristan Tracy of the OU band, and I'm going to ask them a couple questions. So, how much do you guys practice?
2 hours a day. 2 hours a day, 3 to 4 times a week.
That is a lot. And do you get to go to all the games?
We go to all the home games, and then away games are selected. Everyone went to the Notre Dame game, everyone's going to the Texas game, and everyone's going to the OSU game. Kansas State, it's upperclassmen. Kansas is a couple of band fraternities, and then Baylor, it is by auditions.
All right, and what's your guys' favorite food?
Our favorite food is spaghetti.
Okay, thank you guys very much. It's great.
Recently, Eddie Johnson and Aaliyah Howard made it to the ECO CDA Honor Choir. We go now to an interview with Mrs. Cloud about choir.
I'm Alaska with Panther News, and I'm here with Ms. Cloud, the choir teacher, and I'm going to ask her a couple questions. So, how has choir been doing so far this year?
We've been really excited this year, Alaska, because we've got a bigger group than we've ever had. We've had more guys than we've ever had, so we need more guys at the second semester. That's really exciting to have a big men's section this year. We've already gone through our first round of honor choir auditions. We're getting ready for our fall concert, and Christmas is coming soon, so we're excited this year.
So you mentioned some upcoming concerts. Like, do you know when those are or what you'll be doing for those in particular?
Our first concert is going to be a multicultural concert, and we're really excited. We usually bring in extra bands to come and sing with us, but this year we're changing things up and we're having cultural dancers come. So we've got a group of Irish dancers that are going to come and dance for us. We're trying to get the Chickasaw dancers, and we're hoping to book an African dance group.
You guys just recently did ECOCDA. Could you maybe explain what that is and how did you guys do?
Sure. That's the East Central Oklahoma Choral Directors Association Honor Choir. There's three of these groups in the state. We've got East and West and then Central. But the ECOCDA is the largest honor choir in the state. And so we have about 1,200 students from the east side, everything east of I-35. 1,200 students go and they learn all of their music, and then it's a surprise cut. So they don't know really what they're going to audition for. It's about a 3-minute audition. And then they take the top, I believe, 25 from each section, and then they'll get to sing in Guthrie at an honor choir festival. And so for our group, we had, I think, 33 students audition and 8 students make it. So proportionately, we had a really great showing. I'm really proud of them this year.
Okay, awesome. And thank you for this interview.
Thank you.
And now over to Tanner with his special guest for the weather.
Hi, I'm Tanner Hamilton. I'm the chief meteorologist here at Panther News. And this week we have a special guest, Adam Lambert. It's supposed to be cold next week. Thanks, Adam.
You're welcome.
Have a nice day.
We now go to Madison with sports.
Welcome to Sports on Panther News. This weekend, our cross-country teams are traveling to Norman for regionals, so we wish them the best of luck. And this Friday, our football team is going to Atoka in hopes of a huge win this week. So good luck to our football boys. Come support at kickoff at 7:30.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Dexter Dutton.
And I'm Marissa Gordon.
Stay classy, Falls Valley.
Don't run into electric poles. Nathan 9.